So I got a confession to make. I haven't really been into anime the past 6 to 8 months. To be quite honest, the only anime I've watched since maybe November, December, were the three that I recently put reviews out for. I was getting to a point where I was starting to get anxiety about my feelings towards anime. I mean, I am getting older. I'm no longer 12 or 13 or 16 or 18. Shit, I'm no longer even 21. And when you start to have these thoughts, you tend to wonder if what your parents or elders said when you were a kid really might be true. That anime and video games and cartoons and whatever other hobbies we grew up pumping hours of our lives into is just a phase that we'd eventually mature out of. I really was starting to wonder, until one of my subscribers asked me to do a review for a particular anime. An anime I've been seeing since 2016. An anime I did remember enjoying, but kinda would brush off doing a review and a rewatch for it. But I had no particular anime that I was watching at that very moment, so I told him I got him, and that very next morning I popped in the show. And I couldn't even believe it. Great Teacher Onizuka is absolutely one of the greatest anime of all time from any era. The stories, the morals, values, ethics, life lessons this show has to offer is downright timeless. And although it is a beloved and well-respected anime about those who know of its existence, I would say it falls into the pocket of other endangered anime series from the late 90s that never really got their true roses. 22-year-old Aikichi Onizuka is a former gang member turned teacher with much more of a cerebral perspective on life than people give him credit for. Can I say I blame people for their initial judgments of him? Absolutely not. He's a goofy, lecherous, immature virgin and is driven by his perverted motives towards young girls. Not just young girls, he messes with women his age too, but I digress. Now behind all these flaws, Onizuka is dedicated to be the greatest teacher breathing when he develops a disdain for the education system. He believes they are way too condescending towards students and their needs, and he is willing to single-handedly be the change these students deserve. I know this sounds like a pretty simple premise, but you gotta believe me. This was executed in such a beautiful manner that you can't help but smile when you watch majority of these stories. It's not as simple as helping these kids with their homework or self-esteem. It goes deeper than that, as he often finds himself caught up in the home and the personal lives of many of the other characters. The anime is broken up into a bunch of small stories, majority of which revolves around one of Onizuka's students from Holy Forest Academy, where he lands a job at the start of the series, and 9 out of 10 times this student initially isn't very fond of him, setting out to get him fired and ultimately ruin his life. Other episodes revolve around a few teachers, and of course I can't forget the beta-ass vice principal, and no matter what he's dished out, Onizuka is able to work around it and still changes their lives. As the show progresses, you as the viewer is rewarded more and more the satisfaction to see how much Onizuka grows on everyone. By the time you get to the last third of the series, multiple students who initially hated Onizuka develop the same passion they once put into trying to destroy him, working together to make sure his job is secure. It's absolutely amazing. When I think about GTO, it reminds me of what I ultimately got into anime for initially. The same thing that drove us to want to consume all these series or play video games or watch TV shows, hang out with friends, whatever we spend hours of our days doing. We almost get caught up and we forget. Entertainment, pleasure, fun, a smile on our faces. That's what I experienced watching the show, and I haven't really got this feeling watching anime for a while now. The art style and animation are pretty standard here, and I almost feel like this production is quite before its time. Not ahead of its time, before its time. Before its time basically means it comes across as something older than it actually is. For an anime that dropped in 1999, Onizuka tends to look something from 94 or 96. I mean, anything before 2000 pretty much is gonna be blatantly dated, but this one really is one of the last anime of its kind to be 99% totally animated from cells. The soundtrack is absolutely wonderful, a great blend of jazz, hip-hop, and alternative punk. GTO ran from June 1999 to September 2000, clocking in 43 episodes. It was produced by Studio Piro, who actually is known for some of anime's most holy grail series, and Noriyuki Abe was the head director. The manga ran from 97 to 02, spanning 25 volumes written by Toru Fujisawa, and a 12-episode television drama actually predated the anime, aired in Japan in 98. There was also a live-action film that premiered December 99, and Other television dramas and movies were also released in the new millennium as well. As of today, Onizuka stands as an out-of-print product as far as home media goes, but I was lucky to get this back in 2016 off Kijiji in a rare haul for like $25 along with some other out-of-print series. I got very lucky. So you'll have to do some eBay or Amazon hunting to collect something like this. All in all, calling Onizuka a classic is the epitome of an understatement. So do yourself a favor and drop whatever mediocre show that you're probably watching right now and start this up, because I can almost bet my life it isn't more enjoyable than this. And here wraps up another episode. Like the video, comment down below what y'all want to see next. I'm out. Thanks for watching. Anime Back When.